Hey guys, this is Austin, and today I'm here with part 3 of my tutorial on building a gaming PC. The last two parts went over putting the computer together, so now let's get Windows installed and see how it performs. There are several ways to install Windows 7 or 8, whichever you prefer. The first step is to buy the Windows System Builder DVD, which I have linked in the description, as well as in the full build guide where I go over all of the parts in this build. The easiest way is if you chose to install an optical drive in your build, but you can also use a USB DVD drive. If you don't have either of these, you can download and install the Windows ISO on a USB drive and just use the activation code from your physical DVD. Turn on the computer and hit the delete key to enter the BIOS. Every motherboard manufacturer sets this up slightly differently, but while you're here, take a look to make sure everything is displaying correctly. Do you see all of your RAM listed? Is it at the correct speed? How about your hard drive and CPU? Once you're sure everything is correct, go to advanced mode and set your boot order to either the optical drive, USB optical drive, or USB hard drive depending on how you're installing Windows. Make sure the optical drive or USB drive is connected, and then click the override to boot from your installation media. From here, Windows will begin installing. Just plug in your activation code when it asks for it and follow the prompts. If you have more than one hard drive, choose custom installation and then pick whichever drive you want Windows on, typically your SSD if you have one. Now, just let Windows install and you're good to go. Time for a demo of gameplay. The first game is Far Cry 3, which is not only a ton of fun, but it's also among the best looking games to date. The settings are at 1080p with DirectX 11 turned on, 2x anti-aliasing, and the graphics set to high. You can see the frame rate in the top left corner stays in the 40s for the most part, occasionally dipping into the 30s, which is still perfectly playable.
And your mind will follow. The Tatao will bring you closer.
Next, we have Battlefield 3, which is another game that delivers some excellent graphics. Here again, we're playing at 1080p with 2x anti-aliasing and all graphics settings set to high, and we could probably turn things up just a bit, especially in the campaign. The computer is able to pull between 40 and 50 frames per second for the most part, while still keeping well over 30 in multiplayer. So there you have it, the full tutorial and demo of performance of the $600 gaming PC. If you guys are interested in building one of these for yourself, check out the full build guide here, as well as part 1 and part 2 of the tutorial to see how to put it all together. If you enjoyed, be sure to hit up that like button and subscribe. Anyway, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Core i3 for only about $120. For a graphics card, we're going to be using a Gigabyte Radeon HD 7850. Set the cover back down and push the arm down to hold it into place. You'll have to put a lot of pressure on it, but don't worry, this is normal.